NSABP B32, I just take two clinical trials. The NSABP B32 and the value of ultra staging. So in this randomized trial of 5,611 patients, they were only looking at sentinel lymph node with one HNA. And so with that, you can capture easily the micrometastasis and some of the micrometastasis, but not the isolated tumor cells. So you had one group with sentinel lymph node and axillary lymph node dissection, and the second group with sentinel lymph node alone, and you had axillary dissection only if you find a metastatic sentinel lymph node. They had a long follow-up, and the endpoint was overall survival. It was very interesting to see that there was no differences in overall survival, disease-free survival, and regional control between the two groups. And so this one was one of the trials saying that sentinel lymph node status was enough and axillary dissection could be avoided. But what was interesting in this clinical trial is that when the sentinel lymph node was said negative, they were going back to the blocks and doing more cuts to look at what was called occult metastasis. And so they could find isolated tumor cells or micrometastasis. And what was shown in this clinical trial is that there was no difference in the overall survival, even if they found small tumor deposits in the lymph nodes, in the sentinel lymph nodes. So the author conclude that additional evaluation, including immunohistochemistry stains and multiple level of sentinel lymph node, are not indicated because the clinical benefit was not significant. So this clinical trial showed us that probably ultra staging of the sentinel lymph node doesn't bring any benefit to the patient. If you find a macrometastasis, it's important, but finding a micrometastasis or isolated tumor cells, probably now with the treatment and with radiation therapy, this doesn't bring anything to the patient. So after this trial, we had guidelines, and routine immunohistochemistry is not recommended by ASCO, NCCN, and ESMO in Europe. And multi-step level section and immunohistochemistry are not recommended by CAP and UK guidelines, the RCP. Another clinical trial also was interesting. It was the ACOZOG Z011. This clinical trial was looking to the fact that you avoid axillary dissection even if you have a positive sentinel lymph node. And you can see that there is no difference in terms of survival in the two groups, so the group with axillary dissection and the group with sentinel lymph node alone. So what are the results of this clinical trial? They showed that patients with T1 and T2 tumors with less with one or two positive sentinel lymph node treated with breast cancer conservative surgery plus radiation therapy, those patients, they don't benefit from axillary lymph node dissection. So if you see in the table, you can see that we had a patient with macrometastasis and micrometastasis in this clinical trial. And in fact, when we look at 6.3 years, the level of axillary relapse was low. There was no difference between axillary lymph node dissection and sentinel lymph node alone, with axillary relapse of 0.5 in one group and 0.9 in the other group, and local regional relapses, 3.1 in a group and 1.6 in a group. So So this clinical trial made a lot of noise. It has a lot of critics because it was the population in the clinical trial was probably a very good prognosis population with low with the tumors were not very aggressive. Well, more most of the patients were menopausal patients with low grade and small tumors, but nevertheless made a lot of noise in the surgical community. And the data were confirmed by other clinical trials. So the conclusion of this trial and of two other trials was that completion of axillary lymph node dissection is not providing benefit in OS and DFS in microscopic metastatic sentinel lymph node, so PN0 I plus and PN1 micrometastasis. Even macrometastasis in one or two sentinel lymph node in the ACOSOD trial did not affect overall survival. And their conclusion was that sentinel lymph node biopsy alone can be a standard practice demonstrating its efficacy, accuracy in staging, and equivalent survival outcome when compared to complete ALMD and sentinel lymph node biopsy alone in T1, T2 breast cancer. So this was a very big change in practice, saying that in fact, even with a positive one or two positive sentinel lymph node, in those group of patients, you don't do axillary lymph node dissection. It was confirmed by two other clinical trials, the IBCHG 2301 and the AMAROS trial. So now the data from ACOSOG that were criticized are also confirmed by two other clinical trials. And on the contrary, we should perform axillary lymph node dissection. Of course, if the patient has a positive lymph node clinically, we don't perform sentinel lymph node biopsy when you have positive lymph nodes. When the tumor is T3 or T4 with positive lymph nodes, when we have more than free HNE plus sentinel lymph node with extracapsular invasion, node fusions, with sentinel lymph node positive and an indication of mastectomy, because after that it will be complicated to go back to the axillary dissection. And if, of course, the patient cannot be treated by adjuvant treatment, systemic treatment, or radiation therapy because she has already been treated or stuff like that. So this was the message that some patients should receive axillary lymph node dissection. What is the implication for routine practice? The implication is that systematic intraoperative examination of sentinel lymph node is no longer justified. So that's the reason why, as I said to you at the beginning, in my hospital, we don't do anymore systematic intraoperative evaluation of sentinel lymph node. We have also stopped doing immunohistochemistry. We are still doing three levels of HNE, but I don't know if we are going to do that for a long time, but we have still kept that. One last slide, because you already had this talk yesterday, so I'm not going into details longer, but you know that there is also a possibility of doing sentinel lymph node biopsy for patients having a neoadjuvant chemotherapy. This is in the ASCO guidelines. Most of the team are performing sentinel lymph node before neoadjuvant chemotherapy, of course in the absence of a clinically positive lymph node. As I said, I'm not going to go into details because it was treated yesterday. There is a very low level of false negative rate, and the detection rate is between 95% and 100%. So in conclusion, for sentinel lymph node, no longer systematic intraoperative assessment. In case of a positive sentinel lymph node, axillary lymph node dissection is no longer systematic and has to be discussed in a multidisciplinary tumor board. Ultra stratification, the balance between what is useful for the patient or not, and should not be deleterious, because we have a risk and we have probably over-treated patients during the last 15 years for isolated tumor cells or for very small foci of micrometastasis that we would never have found if we haven't performed immunohistochemistry and multiple levels. One thing is that we have to be careful when we use molecular signatures, Oncotype DX, Adopredict, Prosigna, because those signatures were performed when people had axillary lymph node detection. So when the knowledge of the node status was knowledge on the total axillary lymph node dissection. And today, if we are performing molecular signature, for instance, for a patient with one positive lymph node at sentinel lymph node without axillary dissection, I'm not completely sure that we have the right to do that because we have no clinical data on the patient with axillary lymph node dissection. Not if the sentinel lymph node is negative, but if it's positive, I don't know if we have data for that. We also have to decide and to make a balance between what is possible or not in the lab. I remember a long time ago we were doing immunohistochemistry during the surgery. So very quick procedure of immunohistochemistry. It was a lot of work for the technician and the pathologist, and today we are not doing anything bad. So it's a very big change. And it will depend also upon the guidelines, what will be done to the patient. So in fact, the message for a sentinel lymph node is that what is important is not the sentinel lymph node, it's the tumor, the breast tumor by itself, and what will be the treatment after that. And you will be probably more tolerant on the status of the sentinel lymph node if you know that you will have chemotherapy after than if you are not. And for neoadjuvant chemotherapy, you have two options. And usually people prefer to do that before neoadjuvant chemotherapy, but it's also totally possible after neoadjuvant chemotherapy. Thank you very much.